7 days of prayer for our government. Carefully study and read 1 Timothy chapter 2. Paul the Apostle gives us direct instructions to pray for our government. It's an incredible chapter, and there's much to glean from what Paul wrote. Remember, the Bible is the inspired word of God. The Holy Spirit moved on the hearts and the minds of men. These are not Paul's words. These are the words from heaven. 7 days of prayer and fasting for our government. Thanks for joining me on my morning sunrise prayer walk. I'm on top of Mount Diablo. Oh, what a glorious day that it is. The air quality has improved. The weather is mild. And what a spectacular sunrise. But we're here praying and fasting for our government. Paul the Apostle wrote in the next few verses found in 1 Timothy chapter 2 that we are to honor, show respect, and to submit to our governments. That's a pretty tough cookie to swallow. But we need to be sensitive to the Holy Spirit, for the Bible is the Word of God, and it's the same yesterday, today, and forever. It was for Joseph, Daniel, Nehemiah, and Mordecai, four righteous men that grew up as slaves in pagan countries. But when we seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, all these things will be added unto you. As we pray for the government and you study 1 Timothy chapter 2, I want you to observe with me that Paul never said, God never instructed you and I to like the government. He did tell us to pray for the government. Oh, there are certain leaders that you highly respect and esteem, and you really like them, and it's very easy to follow them. But every once in a while, you come across somebody or something that you just have no taste for. That does not weaken the Word of God. It doesn't dilute the Word of God. It only emphasizes the more need there is to pray. Thank you for joining me on my morning prayer walk on top of Diablo Peak. And thank you for praying and fasting for our government. Tomorrow, there's a ballot measure to recall the governor of the state of California. Be in prayer. Ask God to guide and direct. Ask God to bless the state of California with righteous leadership. Oh, I'm not on top of this peak this morning to bring judgment or condemnation upon any man. I'm here to proclaim the Word of God and what the Bible teaches. Oh, to be led and yield to the Holy Spirit. God is able to do great and mighty, mighty things. You be blessed today as you seek His face, as you pray for our government. In Jesus' name. And remember, God loves you, and so do I. You be blessed today, in Jesus' name.